Hey everybody, welcome back to Staying Kingdom Minded. My name's Amanda, if you're new here. And what's this, you ask? Well, this, my friends, you can find in the description box below. It is the Prayer Journaling for Beginners book that I wrote with over 28 original writing prompts in it that is just to help you guide your prayer journaling. So if you're interested, check out the description box below and pick this up. I also have a PDF printable that you can find on my website linked below as well. Today I wanted to talk to you about Romans 8 and 28, the often misunderstood and misused Bible verse. It's a daily devotion. Of course, we're going to cover our Christian writing prompt, and if you've missed any of the videos so far in the month of February, go ahead and check that description box below because I have a playlist that I posted down there just for you with your name on it so you can get caught up. Okay, so we're going to look at day 11, and this is how the writing prompt reads. God, in my heart, I know you can help, but in my mind, oh honey, I worry, what if you, dot, dot, dot. Have you at times wondered, what if you don't come through for me this time like you have before? What if you don't make a way in the midst of this chaos where I really need your hand to move in my life? Have you been tempted to worry, what if you, God, don't do blank for me? You see, I know you've done it before. I know that the word of God, especially Romans 8 and 28, which tells me that all things work together for the good of those that love the Lord, and I love the Lord, and I'm assuming you do too. If you're watching this video, comment below and let me know if you've ever worried, what if you? Just a simple yes or no. Have you ever struggled with the worry of what if you don't do blank? What if you do allow blank to happen? See, in our humanity, we have struggled with the ability to have that, what is that word? Faith? Faith, which means the evidence of believing in the thing that we haven't seen. We haven't seen this tangible God. But faith says he's there. Faith says that he spoke and nothing became something. That kind of blind faith. You see, what I'm getting at today is that oftentimes we misunderstand what Romans 8 and 28 is telling us. It's not telling us that we're never going to go through hard times. It's not telling us that everything's going to feel warm and fuzzy. We're going to have the emotion, the human physical emotion of being happy all the time, the sense of joy, peace, and contentment that's never going to leave us, that's never going to be fleeting. But no, let's read Romans 8 and 28 in the King James Version, and it reads, "And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose." And if we look at it in one more translation, the NLT says, "And we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to his purpose for them." His purpose. Not Amanda's purpose for Amanda, not Amanda's purpose for you, but for his purpose for them. You see, we all have a purpose. Paul has been describing the life of Christians on this side of heaven as one of groaning as we long to escape the suffering of this life, as the commentary says, and to be with God. And we wait in sure hope of the day that our bodies will be resurrected and we'll be able to spend all eternity with God. This is what happens here. The word good does not necessarily mean, as I've previously stated, that we are going to have the human emotion. That's not what it means, that we're never going to go through any kind of pain or hardship, as we all know is inevitable. As a human, we are going to endure. We're not always going to be the most financially successful or have our idea of what the best outcome is for our life, because it is his plan for us. The comfort of the verse is that nothing in this life that we go through will have been wasted. See, there's not one tear that you have cried on your pillow that the Lord isn't holding in the palm of his hand. Actually, scripture tells us that he keeps them in a bottle. This is what I want you to walk away from this devotion knowing today, that Romans 8 and 28 is reminding me and is reminding you that his plan, right? His plan for us, it's going to be good. Kind of like hand in hand with Jeremiah 29 and 11, the Lord is just wanting us to know today that it's all going to work for our good. We're going to have hardships. We're going to have hurt. We're going to have failure and experience loss and even devastation as we walk on this earth. But on my writing prompt, I started writing out some bulleted points here, and I put, I worry what if you don't come through for me this time? You see, my son Abel was born with Down syndrome. He had a hole in his heart, and I prayed, and I took a prayer cloth with me when I went to the cardiologist for the follow-up, and I believed that God was gonna heal his heart. And you know what happened? God healed his heart. Isn't that an amazing thing? But listen, this same God that healed his heart, and I had this blind faith to believe that he would, was the same God that when they drew his blood and they told me that he might have a chromosome abnormality, you know what happened? When I prayed and I believed that he wasn't going to, he did. What? He did? How could my perfect baby have a chromosome abnormality? Abnormal meaning not normal, meaning perceived as not good, as not perfect. But the Word of God teaches me that he was fearfully and wonderfully made. Why do I continue to share that story with you over and over? It's because even in the midst of having blind faith that God was going to move the way that I thought that he should, it was his plan that mattered, not Amanda's want or desire, not my desire for my normal life as I had always known it to be with typically developing children, but his plan, his good plan. Even when it doesn't feel good, even when it doesn't look good, even when you go through loss and you're broken and your heartache is almost more than you can take, the Bible tells us in Romans 8:28, and we know that all things, and that's another thing I wrote in my journal, God remind me that all means all. It truly does. Hashtag nothing is too much. Hashtag nothing is too small for the Lord. I pray that these prayers, the journaling, the writing prompts, the journal itself, the printable, all the things, I pray that they're blessing you. Comment below and let me know if you're enjoying these videos this month in the month of February. And I have submitted the March Prayer Journaling Prompt book for review. I cannot wait until it's started to get published. And I have some links in the description box for you so that you can get caught up on anything you might have missed. And go ahead and subscribe to the channel. If you know a friend, if you know a sister or a brother in Christ who could really use some daily encouragement, go ahead and send one of the videos there way that has spoke to you, and allow God to lead to you who might need to have this kind of a word spoke right into the midst of their situation today. Go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up. It really shows YouTube I'm doing something over here that other ladies need in their life, and I would super appreciate it. All right. Thanks so much for watching another video on Staying Kingdom Minded, and I will see you tomorrow night. Stay Kingdom Minded in everything you do, and I'll see you tomorrow at 9:30.